Pepper spray and mace are often used interchangeably, but they're two very different things. They're chemically different, and one is much more widely used than the other. Pepper spray uses chemicals derived from hot peppers, while chemical mace uses the same stuff as tear gas. Generally, chemical mace isn't as widely used anymore, and it's not legal in every state. But to add a little extra confusion into the mix, the Cleveland-based company Mace sells self-defense sprays. So let's get into it. What is mace? What is pepper spray? And what are the differences between the two? Phenacyl chloride is an irritant that was popularized by law enforcement in the 1960s. It fell out of favor because it's largely ineffective against those under the influences of drugs and alcohol. It's also illegal in these three states. The name Mace comes from the company that produces these products, like what Kleenex is to tissues or Band-Aid is to bandages. Instead, if you're looking for self-defense spray, you're more likely to come across pepper spray or pepper gel. Oleoresin capsicum is an oil produced by hot peppers and is the active ingredient in pepper spray. And this stuff packs a serious punch. It's an inflammatory agent that expands the capillaries around the attacker's face. Those sprayed may experience dizziness, temporary blindness, nausea, and even difficulty breathing. To put it lightly, a dose of pepper spray to the face feels really, 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 really bad. Unlike chemical mace, pepper sprays and gels are legal in all 50 states. However, there are laws on the books in these places regulating size and contents of the pepper spray. The best way to comply with local laws is to limit your canister to 1.2 ounces with an OC spray content of 10% or less, and make sure it has a safety feature on the canister. Getting something too powerful can literally blow back in your face, leaving you and your attacker in bad shape. That's where pepper gel steps forward. It uses the same active ingredient, but deploys in a thicker stream, lowering your risk of blowback. We've dropped a few links to our favorites in the description if you want to check those out. Long story short, the difference is mostly chemical. What we see as mace today is probably just pepper spray. Chemical mace is considered dangerous, ineffective, and illegal in some places. And while I hope you never need to use it, always call 911 after you use pepper spray on someone. It packs such a punch and it can seriously injure your target. So making this call can help in case that they sustain some serious health issues or try to sue you after an incident. You can check out more links to our personal safety articles and lineups on Safewise.com too. We've got lists of our favorite personal alarms, safety apps, pepper sprays, and even stun guns. Thanks for watching and stay safe. Thanks for watching. And if you want more safety, head over to Safewise.com and you can find reviews and our lineups of best home security systems, best wireless cameras, and more. Stay safe.